You know what you are saying, actually, now, look, if you hear Sir Ahmadu Bello speak English, I was,
or I was even thinking Tafa Balewa.
About Tafa. Perfect Queen's English diction, you know. For me, it was a revelation, the album, you know. And there was the occasion that Sir Abubakar Tafa Balewa addressed the Joint Congress of the U.S. And it was, I don't think any Nigerian leader has ever been given that kind of honor. He addressed the Congress, the Senate, and the House of Representatives. And you could see the flawless diction, his confident comportment. You know, he was, and of course, young. He was, yeah, so it's for us, it's those of us who are, it's a journey of discovery. There are many assumptions and myths about Nigeria that are not true, and from which we have either on the basis of false assumptions, learned negatively or positively from. But the chief thing, we were talking about Chief Awolo went to, at the one of the London Constitutional Conference. Chief Awolo was saying hello to Sir Ahmadu Bello. And he said first, Ahmadu Bello didn't respond. So he's asking, what was the problem? I'm greeting you. And Ahmadu Bello told him that, look, I'm angry because one of your lieutenants saw me here and didn't say hello, which was bad manner. And Awolo had to go and drag the person. He said, look, come and apologize and don't ever do it again. If you do so, you'll be duly prepared. That is etiquette. That is decency. That is correct, political correctness. Regardless of the fact that you are a political opponent, the underlying social etiquette that brings society was there. You know, the values, you know, it was a functional society. You know, at that time, I used to tell people that when we were in secondary, when we were young, many people aspired to become professors. But professors were respected members of the middle class. You permanent security, you know. Unlike these days that, look, somebody said, if you introduce somebody as a professor, people will laugh at you. So it's a process, a journey of discovery for Nigerians, and from which we can learn about, you know, that we need, it is called a rounded education, you know. You see a lot of ignorance on display these days, you know, because people don't seem to, I don't know what to do, they're incomplete and selective, you know, fractious memory. People just jumble facts together these days and present it as opinion.
Even so, we who read some of Nigeria's history, who were actually alive when these things happened, there was some information, well, there was a lot of information yet, which was imparted yesterday, which a lot of us didn't know about. Yeah, so what do you think is going to be the fate of young Nigerians? Because history is no longer on the school curriculum.
Yeah. I mean, so I think the person who represented Governor Fashola made the point that generation, maybe the recent generations or whatever, that they look at the TBS. Those of them who bother to know what TBS stands for, know they say the name is Tafa Balewa, but they didn't know who he was. I mean, imagine the functional illiteracy. They didn't know who he was, the first prime minister of Nigeria. And you find that thing, it is funny. I mean, it's not funny. Because it cuts across. It is not a minor problem or exceptional. It is probably the root. You know? Yeah. That is a reflection, a sad reflection on the poverty of education in Nigeria today.
So how should people like Okoti Abor and Tafa Balewa, how should they be remembered?
Well, you know, in terms of what they contributed, in terms of the standard of performance in office, You know, one of the things that we also learned, I remember one about K.O. Mbadi, who had a problem with Dr. Nnamdi Azikiwe, and he was thereby, you know, he was a ministerial nominee. Zeke withdrew his nomination and was about sending him out of the party. He actually did. Tafawa Balewa now took him in as his own staff that he could not have, he doesn't want such a talent to be wasted. And, you know, on his own, you know, then went out to make the case for him with Zeke, and eventually he was restored to. Now you see leaders from different parties, you know, that even regardless of their, you know, how they were relating to one another, and, you know, it showed that the easy, you know, confidence that people had with one another, you mix freely, you, even the one that Maitama Sule also told us, you know, that the Prime Minister once told him that when they're having the dinner party, he wouldn't want to go and dance or open the floor. He wanted Maitama Sule to go and do it. And of course, Maitama Sule was so happy and was looking forward to it so much. And that when he was saying that, he said he could forgive Okutiyemo, but not forget that.
Forget.
And Okutiyemo then went to the father. If you are not going to open the floor, then the honor should be given to me, not to
not Maitama.
So he was, and you know, that is that. If people are able to relate very well at that level, it also helps in the management of political conflict. If I have a very good social relations with you, it's a very good foundation for us to, you know, see things mutually, to agree to disagree. And when you disagree, it doesn't degenerate into animus or malice or whatever it is. Yeah, that was a functional society.
Someone did say that these leaders, they were not just leaders, that they were nationalists, and therefore, for him, heroes.
Well, I don't think, I'm not very comfortable with the word. I think he meant cosmopolitan. Whatever anybody may say about it, look, the thing about 1966 or from 1960 was that the three dominant parties were actually ethno-regional parties. Now, there's no way you can refer to that people who operated those things as national. They were cosmopolitan, which is different from being a nationalist. It doesn't, will not fall into those demarcations. But they were able to manage it well. And it does not need to generate conflict. People will say, well, that it is logical anyway. You are a Yoruba man first before you are a Nigerian, you know. Doesn't mean that both, they are not in conflict. It's mutually inclusive. So there is really nothing, all these epithets and things, you can have a patriot, a man can be patriotic, but I don't want to, the word nationalist has been bastardized. What would you call the schoolmakers of 1966? They were acting in the interest of the country, you know, in their own way. Were they nationalists? What do you call them? I mean, these are questions. So these are areas we have to be very used and very careful about using, over romanticizing the First Republic. There was a problem in not giving them enough recognition. But we shouldn't go to the other extreme, you know, of over-romanticizing them, you know.
Okay, so let's wrap this up now. So how do you then think that these people should be remembered and should be honored?
How do we get the younger ones to hook up to the history and remember?
Well, you know, it is difficult to ask a hungry man to learn. You see, we're in a, no, that is the truth. We're in an emergency situation in the country. You have first-class graduates these days, they can't find jobs. So there is a fundamental crisis, you know, which you have to resolve first. Many people don't have the luxury of, you have to also realize that maybe a lot of the ignorance is not by choice. It may be circumstantial, it may be willfulness, but a lot of it. So there are fundamental issues that we need to address. And the most pressing now is actually economy. And probably, you know, the political structure of the country. But what you have said is not mutually exclusive. I mean, we can also get it to... it's only that, as I said, it will be difficult to catch the attention of people on anything that is not immediate now. People are confronted with the immediate solution to urgent problems. But we have to keep that at the background. And somebody made a very eloquent case for the remembrance, recognition of Chief Opotiebo. And that is the fact that his picture should be on one of the currencies. That you, having been responsible for giving life to these institutions, major institutions, economics, that is actually jumping the gun to go. You recognize governors of central banks, putting their pictures there, but the man who actually caused those institutions to be given birth in the first place. So Chief Opotiebo can be a symbol, you know, of rectifying what is wrong with the history of Nigeria, showing gratitude, as people put it yesterday.
Okay. Former presidential spokesperson Akin Oshun-Tokun, thank you very much for coming to share your insights with us.
I was political advisor, not exactly. But that can pass. I will let it.
Thank you. Thank you. Sunrise will return in just a moment. Please don't go away.